I call check-in meditation, just to see what's available right now, what kind of energy is present, but just check to see what kind of energy you bring to this moment. Energy in this sense, there are many ways to talk about, many layers this body has. So physical level, physically, then emotionally, and mentally, and perhaps spiritually, you know, what kind of state or what kind of mood bring to this moment. So just rest in that. As you know, we cannot think, we cannot use intellect for this one. We have to really sense it, feel into it, connect it. May not be able to put into language, but still you can experience it, right? Then I want you to rest in that. So just let's do that for a few minutes. So breath is the key. So just breathe in, breathe out, as if breath is a nurturing, loving attention, scanning layers or tapestry of the body without any judgment. So bring your affectionate curiosity to see if you can notice any energies or where you are energetically right now at this moment. Then I want you to start deepening your breath. And I want you to invite to this final inquiry for this short session. What's your relationship to the sacred? Or what's your relationship to this source or infinite or timeless, whatever adjective you can use. But what is your relationship, this sense of, your sense of source, core at this moment? You can say refuge. What you hold as sacred. Allow your breath to go wherever it goes. Perhaps if you are like me, breathe deeply onto the lower belly, very smooth and deep. So perhaps without answering to this question exactly like, okay, this one. No, just hold that question with you and see if you can live or you can practice with that question without necessarily answering to that. Just energetically hold it. No, what's the source? What's my sacred? So in Vajrayana practice, as you know, life is sacred. No, that's the premise of Vajrayana. Life is sacred, whatever that means to each of us. Then each of us is a big part of that tapestry of life. You know, we are weaving. It's all aspect of who we are. Is a big part of that sacred. And then this body, each of us, we have this body. Body in a sense that not just a physical body. You by now you know body has all layers and sacred within. So that body is an altar. Altar kind of temple where we can access to that sacred. So what we have been doing since today is the last session of this series, a little bit of review what we have been doing. At least my intention was to what's standing in a way of viewing life is sacred, life is a gift. You know, sometimes why I'm not always feel that way? You know, is that only me? You know, sometimes life doesn't feel like a sacred, no? And my body is not like altar at all, the worthy of worship. So then we ask another question, if you like, in your daily life, what's standing in a way of viewing that, living life that way? So then this practice comes in, that I call Subtle Body Training. And especially this series is called Vajra Body Integration. So integrating. Another aspect of Vajrayana is we integrate everything, every aspect of the human expression, not only just quietly sitting, meditation, you know, that's possible. But another aspect of Vajrayana is we accelerate or we make it speed up by using all these things. For example, we use the mudra, we use the chanting, we use dancing, expression of body, and also in the mantra, of course, all these physical body exercises, movement, everything we use. So in Vajrayana, we use everything in disposal without discarding every part of it. Even so-called conflicted emotions, we went over a little bit, no? How we can keep our heart open in the midst of conflict. So we use everything. So then I call integration. Then Vajra body. Vajra is immutable, right? Not destroyed, so deathless. So slowly through this kind of process, unveiling process, or unlocking the potential or power of potential, then we discover or we come to know our body, or we are deathless, beyond death and birth. In other words, emptiness. That's called the Vajra body, deathless body. So those are things we are weaving. Tantra. Tantra is another etymology of weaving. So we are weaving all aspects of the synergies or element together. So today is kind of the culmination, but the end of the section. So I want you to really enjoy whatever you've done so far and see if you can rest in that experience. So Tantra Vajrayana cannot be learned, I have to say this way, because there's a lot of books on the bookshelf. No, we cannot be learned. It can be revealed. It's something to be revealed, which means the key to that revelation is our direct experience. So that's what we have been doing, direct experience, whatever it may be. Then in order to have an authentic direct experience, authentic experience, we need a link to the timeless tradition. So this subtle body training is a link to the timeless tradition. Timeless in that sense, that tradition with those masters who realize that, who have that revelations. And we are a big part of that stream right now. So we're going to bring this to our life. Then every moment of our life become a sacred. And we appreciate the gift we have right now. Whatever life presents, not despite of what's going on in life.